you there, guys. SC Mothership checking back in, and we've got a little bit of change of scenery here. We're on game number 3 of WhiteRa versus DIMAGA. DIMAGA taking game number 2, tying it up. Obviously, we have 1 for WhiteRa taking game number 1, and the map is Terminus. I do not know which version. There's so many different versions. There's like Terminus SE, there's Terminus RE, there's just Terminus. But this is the one with a 5 mineral patch, third base, and a one geyser, not rich vespine geyser, low ground, and there are rocks here in the back. I've seen versions of this map where there aren't any actual rocks here. It's just kind of a cliff, and obviously then there's this version with the rocks in it. I've seen versions without this smoke vent, so just very, very peculiar. One interesting feature I always like to come back to on this map is the 420 right here. I mean, I know it's supposed to be 42, like, radiation, but come on, Blizz, come on, really? Anyways, we do see WhiteRa taking the scout here. Let me talk about the players here. Obviously, this is WhiteRa. He is playing the race called Protoss. They're the little alien dudes. They've got these robot dudes that mine minerals. They're pretty, pretty good at it, but the Zerg race also has something to counter the Protoss probes. They're called drones, and they can actually fly. I don't know if you knew about that, but they're actually flying. That's yet to be proven, but they are flying. Anyways, DIMAGA obviously playing Zerg. He is in the rightmost position. And interesting thing about this map, in case you hadn't noticed here, it's really frickin' large. We have this large open area here in the center. We've got 4 watchtowers, one located here, here, and here. And interestingly enough, this watchtower can actually look at the 2 adjacent towers and see if there's anything on them. So keeping control of one watchtower actually gives you control of 2 others. And oh, holy crap, we're actually seeing WhiteRa going for the Forge Fast Expand once again, but attempting to cannon rush DIMAGA here. DIMAGA pulling off 6 drones here to deal with the pylon here, and actually canceling another one, positioning these drones in key locations so that cannons cannot be placed down. And in such a fashion that they would be walled off against other drones. Now, this drone actually going to be able to get in from the inside, and this cannon's taking some good amount of damage, but WhiteRa deciding to cancel it. Obviously, the DPS is too much, and I will hold up a second because my textures are going crazy. All right there, guys. Sorry, I strongly apologize for that. Once again, my texture's just going crazy. I know it sucks to look at that. It sucks to have your game ruined like that, but let's jump right back into it. We do see WhiteRa now having that expansion up already, so trying to apply a little bit of pressure and hopefully to throw his opponent off guard a little bit, trying to make him overcommit. I mean, obviously, he had those drones not mining for the short amount of time, but, I mean, really, the hatchery wasn't up. He needed to transfer them anyway. So, I mean, the amount of mining loss is a little bit questionable. But, obviously, the minerals lost from canceling buildings and this one pylon actually hurts WhiteRa quite a bit. We're seeing this first proton cannon come down. And expansion wasn't delayed by too much. Actually, one thing I realized now that one thing I forgot to do is get rid of the game timer. And one thing I forgot to put Mac on was the game timer. So, for those of you who really like to look at timings and wish to see the timings of which things go down, there you go. Sorry that it wasn't up in the previous game. We're seeing the first gas just now finishing at the 448 mark. Now they've got the timer. I can accurately depict that, but I hate Blizzard timer because it's so misleading. It'll be in the game and it'll be like 20 minutes. You'll be like, oh man, I've been in this game for 20 minutes, but it's really only been about 16 minutes if you're a normal human being. But yeah, this Nexus now just finishing, and right when that Nexus finishes, we have a third one going right up. So WhiteRa just playing the super, super heavy aggression, but I'm pretty sure DIMAGA, let's take a look, DIMAGA is completely aware of the fact that WhiteRa is taking that third, and in response, he says, all right, I'll just take my third too. Pretty interesting choice there by DIMAGA, but deciding, obviously, that he can be the better macro player. He probably thinks that he can secure his fourth really, really quickly and take an aggressive stance on the map and prevent WhiteRa from taking his fourth. And I like that idea. I think it is pretty good. Zerg has that capability. It's a very quick mobile unit, so they're very, very good at denying bases. And this probe actually going to get in, get some mediocre scouting. I was going to say some really good scouting, but that queen kind of came in and cock-blocked that. This third is base is about two-thirds done now at this point, and WhiteRa's third base is just now finishing. We're seeing Corona boost out a ton of probes. Let's take a look at the probe count of both players. DIMAGA actually ahead, but WhiteRa just evening the gap there right away. And oh, There's a fourth base. Very, very quickly, let's see what WhiteRa has got in store. He does not know about that. Not that I expect him to find about it or find out about it that quickly, but I mean, hey, weirder things have happened before, and some pretty good Zealot Micro there, actually, able to take out two lanes with only losing 25 shields. If he keeps running like this, yep, the shields did start to regenerate, but there are some more Zerglings, and ooh, this is actually really good positioning there. Only about two Zerglings can actually attack that Zealot if he gets in the right positioning, but now there's about three. Some good Zergling Micro there by Dimaga, and this Zealot is going to go out now. This third base being taken out quite quickly, and oh my god, no. This isn't about to happen. Wow, that is some Gosu senses right there. WhiteRa just instantly finding out about that and instantly puts down the pylon too, saying, ah, hell no, you ain't building there. So I assume is Warp Gate. Let's take a look at the production tag. Yeah, Warp Gate is actually just finishing, and five gateways are finishing behind that. Four are actually finishing right now, and then a fifth one going to be followed up there, bringing him to a total of six gateways. Only running off of three guys is right now getting that fourth one, and not opting to take that fifth one right away. And is that a cannon? Okay, so he's going to be cannon rushing. Let's see. Actually, I can't actually see how many. That's interesting. When a photon cannon is being built, you can't actually see the range there. I'm a little bit skeptical as to why he built the cannon. I mean, these zealots are going to be more than enough to actually kill this base. Assuming they can take out that spine crawler. So the cannon might be a little bit overkill. We're actually seeing another pylon. I feel like he's like cannon rushing the third. Just like saying, get the cannons out, get the cannons out. But I guess now his zealots do have a fallback position, but his zealots can be able to deal out the pain here to the Zerglings and take out this queen really, really easily. Probably going to want to, yeah, there you go, take position some there. Hiding this extra pylon just in case. Let's take a look at the what's going on while this attack is going on, because it's always interesting to see what players are doing in the midst of their micro-ring. We see some Larvan Jux have obviously gone off on all these bases here. We look at WhiteRa is actually not building probes. There you go, just now starting to build up probes. Let's see, this probe's actually just chilling around. So WhiteRa might be the few lower the APM. And ooh, actually Dark Shrine going down by WhiteRa. So I'm glad to have come back and looked at this. And a Robo going down as well. But a lot of Zealots here. So this fourth base is going to get taken out, I feel. And like I feel like Dimaga should have maybe just let it die. He's wasting a lot of units into defending this. And he's just going to lose it anyways. I mean, this is what, the second, maybe even third queen. I mean, that's great. He's going to get an eject off. But the base is going to die before the larva actually pop, and so many Zerglings have died. Let's take a look at the units lost. Oh my god, a thousand lead here for WhiteRa, but Dimaga actually staying ahead in the harvest, or in the food supply, just barely. Now let's take a look at the income tab, and WhiteRa's ahead in the income tab. So I mean, WhiteRa is just playing this off beautifully. He's actually going to probably be able to take out this, no, actually the larva are going to pop, so I'm actually surprised to see those larva get popped there. Blink just about to finish here. We did see plus one a missile attack now going to finish, and I think maybe Tunneling Claws just finished, or some upgrade that just finished here. No burrow, so it probably wasn't close. Just killed the base already, man. Larva keeps spawning, but I feel like Dimaga committed so much to trying to keep this base when, I mean, it was pretty much dead. He can't really keep up with the warping mechanics there, and plus there were cannons being built. And is he, oh wow, he's actually attempting to retake that. So, and Dimaga did find out about that extra pylon there. One cool thing, though, I kind of wish that WhiteRa had done was take a fourth base in the middle of that. Taking a fourth base would have probably substantially helped him out. Because if he can get that fourth base, the fourth base up with cannons, because it's really difficult to actually take a fourth base, but with that large distractionary force, all of Dimaga's units were focused over there. So if he'd gotten that fourth base up, and positioned a ton of cannons there, he could have actually been able to hold off any large roach pushes like this. But obviously WhiteRa deciding not to do that, just gonna be adding on more gateways, maybe just trying to play and get a large army massed up, and then take the field here and go for that fourth base. Let's see what this probe has gotten in store for us. Maybe just some sharking, but let's see. Ooh, a warp prism just now dropping off some DTs at multiple bases. We saw two being dropped here and Two overseers actually being morphed here, so one for every overseer. Okay, wow. A lot of resources actually being wasted just purely on overseers, and these Dark Temples are going to take out the queen. Ooh, I hope he does, because taking out queens actually does a lot to your opponent. I mean, it doesn't seem like much. It seems like 150 minerals, but these are the guys that are, you know, providing four extra larvae every time. So, not losing, actually. Only losing one DT. And, okay, DIMAGA taking a ton of bases here. Now he's got this base defended. He was expecting that exactly what is actually happening. He was expecting some Dark Templars to be dropped here because it's so far away, but got a large amount of roaches, and he's got a Overseer there, losing another DT. Not the greatest thing, but now WhiteRa is moving out just now, taking that fourth base. Something that I feel like he could have done about, you know, 5 minutes ago. But WhiteRa moving everything, and ooh, is he gonna get all these drones in transit? If he just gets those drones, ooh, great sense there. See, noticing those force fields, or those drones there, and Seven gonna get away, but he's also gonna be attacking. I don't know if this is a good idea to leave your whole base like this so bare. He's lucky to see that all these units, well, I guess he knew that these roaches were there, but still, I mean, he's lucky that there isn't some sort of counterattack, and just a small contingent of zerglings or roaches could be doing a lot of damage at his front right now, causing WhiteRa to be split. But obviously DIMAGA deciding that he's got more press or urgent matters to attend to, being this giant ass army at his faraway expansion. This is what I'm talking about. So, oh wow, actually it's a multi-pronged here, the warp prism being able to do a lot of damage here, and WhiteRa is going to catch these roaches off guard as well. So I mean, really WhiteRa is dominating this right now. These there's nothing here to defend with this, so this base is going to get all of its drones taken out. We're seeing WhiteRa take about 20 harvester lead. And with that, I think WhiteRa is shaping up to be in a really, really strong position. This fourth base is now just about to go up, and I feel like this is going to go down as well for DIMAGA. I mean, there's a good amount of Spinecrawlers, but there's a whole freaking army at his front. I mean, I don't care how many Spinecrawlers you build, you don't have enough units there to defend. I mean, that's kind of it. DIMAGA kind of splitting up his army. We saw multiple engagements of small portions of his army, which is really good when the Protoss is trying to defend his own base, but when the Protoss is balling up like that and just sharking across the map, it's not really good to kind of poke at him with small groups of units. And this is what I was talking about now, getting up all these photon cannons and being able to defend these photon cannons. Obviously, buy you time, and having blink as well can help your units survive a little bit longer and help them actually come back to your army if you can blink in here. There you go. And now he's going to be able to defend this no problem, not taking any sort of losses there except for maybe a couple cannons and a good amount of stalkers. But he can afford to lose that after having taken out the fourth base of his opponent for a second time. Well, he also took out that fifth base, so taking out a total of three bases there. WhiteRa, I assume, has an observer. Doesn't actually have an observer with his army, so a little bit, there it is, trailing from behind. Let's say, he does need to pick off these creep tumors, that'll help him a lot. We're seeing corruptors come out, but there aren't any colossi. That's one interesting thing I've noticed about a lot of these Protoss players. None of them have opted to go Colossi. In any of the games, even though we're at, you know, the 18-minute mark, you normally expect to see a large number of Colossi. This upgrade is not going to finish, and actually DIMAGA falling behind. We saw in that game versus Hawk where he was just exorbitant in the amount of upgrades, but in this game, not actually opting to get so many upgrades. Charge actually on those Zealots too is helping them reach that front line. The blink on the Stalkers allowing the Zealots to move past, and just providing for a really, really strong army composition. These Immortals able to deal out the damage, and I feel like DIMAGA is going to be faltering here. We see WhiteRa taking his WhiteRa taking his fifth base, and the Spire is going down, and DIMAGA saying GG and grats. So WhiteRa taking game number 3 of this best of 3 series. Really, really well played by WhiteRa. He really stepped it up in that last game. I like the warp prism tactics. He's always been one dude with special tactics, but I mean, just showing how well or how good he is at it and how effective the warp prism can be. We're seeing now with the recent, relatively recent buff to the warp prism, it being used a lot more in a staple fashion. Anyways, you guys, I'm not going to try and ramble on like I have been in the end of most of the games. So I'm just going to end it with SC Mothership checking out.